terrible story. We talked about it yesterday. 10-year-old boy in Miami dies from an overdose of a synthetic opioid. It's fentanyl. Officials say he could have simply touched it, explaining that it could have been on a towel at a swimming pool, or he may have been exposed to it on his walk home. That's how powerful these drugs can be. Just yesterday, an Ohio police officer hospitalized for possible exposure to fentanyl. The officer has been treated and released. Tests are being done to determine exactly what he was supposed to. You know, we talked at length about it around here, opioids, the rise in their use, the rise in the number of overdoses, and the problem for law enforcement in getting a handle on this terrible drug problem. Heroin, fentanyl, carfentanil, hydrocodone, oxycodone, these are just some of the names of these drugs. Colonel Chad Chronister from the Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office is here this morning to talk about where we are in this drug crisis known as the opioid epidemic. Chad, hi. There is a new law that we certainly hope will help here, right?
You're exactly right. I recently signed a new law that dealers of fentanyl can be charged with murder if their customers overdose. This new law also gives prosecutors more muscle to seek prison sentences for anyone caught with fentanyl or other similar opioids.
Let's talk about the law enforcement aspect of that right there. That picture right there gives you an idea of how small the drug is and the danger it can cause, smaller than a penny. Let's talk about law enforcement. Some of these drugs are very dangerous, even for law enforcement just to come in contact with, right?
Russell, and you saw a comparison to a penny. I've seen it before where it's been compared to the top of a pin cap. That's how potent this stuff can be. But fentanyl, carfentanil, super potent pain medication, just a tiny amount can be deadly if inhaled or even exposed to the skin. And not just the human law enforcement, to our canine officers as well. Think about this. Our canines use their sense of smell to do their jobs. If one of them sniffs some fentanyl or heroin, it can absolutely be deadly.
And you brought along something this morning that you guys are now using to keep the canines safe. What is it?
And I hope that they can see this on camera, but a few weeks ago we purchased Narcan for our canines. The deputies and their deputies, who are their handlers, now carry it in their vests. It's a single injectable dose to counter any opioids our dogs may ingest. So we have one for every single one of our 22 dogs now.
And let's talk about Narcan while you've got it right there. A miracle drug?
I wouldn't say a miracle drug, but it certainly does save lives. Narcan can be injected or inhaled, and right now, here in Hillsborough County, fire rescue paramedics handle administering their drug.
Let's talk about the opioid epidemic itself. Not that long ago, we were here talking about pill mills. Now this.
And Florida Attorney General Pam Bondi went full on against pill mills, these fly-by-night businesses that set up shop to simply fill and sell prescription painkillers. Florida was ground zero. We were successful. Now opioids are the problem.
And why this drug? Why opioids?
Russell, it comes down to money. It's all about money. Dealers can cut heroin to make it go further. A $10 high can last for hours. The big danger, though, is that dealers are now taking empty capsules, filling them with heroin or fentanyl, creating their own little cocktail, and selling it as oxycodone. The end user now has no idea, and obviously the consequences can be deadly. In Hillsborough County, we had 41 people die in 2015, 65 in 16, and 35 as of May of this year.
We got to run, Chad, but I want to ask you really fast before we go, what's it going to take to stop this?
It's going to take a collaboration on three fronts. Number one, Governor Scott's done a great job getting out ahead of this and declaring a state emergency, which is providing additional resources for every community in the state of Florida. So obviously, we're targeting the dealers that are creating and distributing these deadly cocktails. But just as important, if not more important, is education. Providing education and then treatment to those that are unfortunately falling victim to addiction for these deadly cocktails.
All right. Chad, thanks. Good to see you as always.
Good to see you too. Have a great day.
You too.